In my previous video you have seen how to check and configure VSS for backup. In this video we will see how to perform VSS troubleshooting needed for backup using VSS admin and Diskshadow tools. This video covers several of the VSS errors that are generated by the Microsoft Windows operating systems and that the backup software reports in the logs. First, check how many fixed drives are configured to the server from my computer. On this server we see only one drive, C. To determine the cause of the VSS errors, let us run few commands on the client and pipe the output to an text file so we can review and discuss later. Open command prompt with elevated privileges, in other words, run as administrator. VSS admin help command will show list of available supported commands to perform troubleshooting. First command, VSS admin list writers. Second command, VSS admin list providers. Third command, VSS admin list volumes. For the fourth command we will use Diskshadow tool that exposes the functionality offered by the volume shadow copy service. Type Diskshadow forward L. Type list writers detailed. Once done, type exit. Let us now review the files we created. VSS admin list writers lists shadow copywriters, which support communicating with the volume shadow copy service to ensure that files are captured in a consistent state. Last error and state of the writer is important to check for any issues with that particular writer. You can also verify if all need writers exist or if some are missing from the server. Missing writers need to be added back to the server. VSS admin list providers lists registered volume shadow copy providers. You might see one or more based on application specific installation and they might be conflicting or causing issues. VS admin list volumes lists volumes that are eligible for shadow copies. It could be fixed drives or mounted volumes on the server. Diskshadow list writers detailed lists the identity and status of writers and displays metadata such as component details and excluded files. This also include full file list for all components. You can analyze the file for any issues, for example an application install path which has backward, is correct, but if you see one with forward, is incorrect and that application need to be fixed. For failed to create a VSS snapshot issues we can try create a snapshot using Windows tools and ensure if it is working right at operating system end. If issues from OS side, then server team need to investigate and fix or check with vendor Microsoft for the fix. Open computer, right-click on drive C and select properties. From Shadow Copies tab, select the volume for which you wish to create snapshot. Click Create Now from Shadow Copies of selected volumes. If Shadow Copy is created successfully, you will see date and time stamp listed. The Shadow Copy is also seen or verified using VSS Admin List Shadows command from command line. You can delete the shadow using GUI or command line. For this video, we will do it using GUI. The other way to create snapshot is using Diskshadow. From admin command prompt, type Diskshadow and hit enter. Type begin backup. Type set context persistent. My bad, let's correct the spelling of persistent. Type add volume C. This is the only volume seen on this server. Type writer verify, and here you need system writer ID, which can be obtained from VSS admin list writers command output file. Type set metadata and pipe the output to system state.cab file. Type set verbose on. Type create. This would create a snapshot of the drive C involving the system writer, and we can see if issues with backup. If snapshot created successfully, then no issues with snapshot creation on the server. Created shadow copy is also seen or verified using VSS admin list shadows command from command line. You can delete the shadow using Diskshadow command, delete shadows with various supported parameters. Thank you for watching. Please share, like, comment and subscribe for more.